Hey everyone, this is 8-Bit Flashback, and I got some huge news that surrounds the Nintendo Switch. Every single Nintendo Switch that's been sold, including all firmwares, can now be exploited. Yesterday, FailOverflow announced a way to exploit the Tegra X1 chip that's on board the Nintendo Switch just by shorting out two pins where your Joy-Cons plug in. So now the Switch is exposed to all kinds of modding. Is this good or bad? So in this article released yesterday by FailOverflow, they discuss how they were able to exploit the Nintendo Switch by basically gaining backdoor access to the Tegra X1 chip on board the Nintendo Switch. And this is achieved by shorting out pins 7 and 10 where your right Joy-Con connects to your Switch console. And to make things easier, they have released a 3D printable file so you can print that out and make the process of shorting those pins out a lot easier. So to exploit the console, we don't have to open it up and replace computer chips and do anything crazy. All we have to do is short out a couple pins, and that gives us backdoor access to the Nintendo Switch. And I did manage to print one of these out just so I can kind of give you a visual of how you short these pins out. So here's a look at the file in my 3D printing software, and I didn't have to mess with the scale or nothing. All I had to do was load the file and then select print. And here's the end result. I have a tiny jig with a couple contact points on it that's designed to short out pins 7 and 10. And to make this, I did have to destroy a micro USB cable. I had to cut that apart and get access to the pins. And those pins happen to be the same distance apart as what's on the Nintendo Switch. Then I soldered two pins together with two spaces in between so I can make contact with 7 and 10. Then I glued the pins in place, and this is what I end up with. Now let's go ahead and attach it to the Switch so I can show you how that goes on. So I'm going to take off the right controller. And now this jig is going to slide right down where that controller goes. And it's going to make contact with 7 and 10 when you push it all the way down. So those two pins make contact with the two pins on the Nintendo Switch. Right there. After shorting out those two pins, this will allow you to communicate with your computer by attaching a USB-C cable. From that point, you can start installing software and modify the Switch's firmware, and allow it to play programs such as Linux and a Dolphin emulator, and both of these have been teased already. So the stage this is at right now is very buggy, and I would say it's not stable, so I would not recommend that anyone messes around with this yet. Unless you're an extremely advanced user that understands coding and developing, this is just not worth messing with at this point. Here in the near future, I would expect there's going to be some easier guides coming out, but at this point, everything is very difficult. So right now, this exploit will work on every single Nintendo Switch that's ever been sold, and there's no update that can stop this either. No matter how many updates it can do, there's no way to stop this exploit. So the only way Nintendo can stop this is with a hardware revision. That means they have to release a new Nintendo Switch with different hardware inside. So for all the existing Switches out there, there's no stopping this. But what they can do is if they find out you've exploited your console, they can ban you from online services, like eShop and online gameplay. And there has been some previous exploits on the Switch, and I've talked about that and made some videos. And that required you to be on firmware 3.00. And all Nintendo had to do to stop that exploit was release a new firmware. But now, like I said, the only way they can fix this is with a hardware revision. Now there's a lot of people out there worried that this is going to be the end of the Nintendo Switch and it's going to become a dead console since it's hacked now, but I don't think that's going to be the case at all. I mean, there's so many people out there that just have no interest in modding or hacking. They just want to go buy a game or buy a game online and just play it. They don't want to deal with any complications. They just want to have the pleasure of playing a game and just have it be easy. Nintendo is a giant company. And they're not going anywhere. They're going to be here for a long, long time. And I'll make sure to post links to all these articles down in the description below that kind of talks about this process a little bit more. And they did mention in the article they will be working on a guide here in the near future to try to simplify this process. That way an average user will be able to do this. Alright everyone, thanks for watching. If you liked that video, please click that like button. If you want to hear more from me, please subscribe. And if you want to help support the channel, you can now find me on Facebook and Patreon. Have a great day. And I'll see you next time.